Dear students of class 6, welcome to you all. My today's topic is the Indus Valley Civilization. It is our chapter 4, the first cities, first urban civilization in India. It is known as Indus Valley Civilization or Harappan Civilization. We see the Indus Valley Civilization was unearthed. It was excavated in the year 1920, 21, and 22. It was that the Dayaram Sahani, an archaeologist, who excavated Harappa in the year 1920. Rai Bahadur Dayaram Sahani. And in 1921-22, Rakhaldas Bandyopadhyay Banerjee excavated Mohenjo-daro. Harappa is situated in the Larkana district of Sindh in Pakistan. Mohenjo-daro is situated in Punjab, in the Punjab district, in Pakistan, in Montgomery district of Punjab in Pakistan. We see that the Mohenjo-daro flourished on the bank of river Indus, and Harappa flourished on the bank of its tributary Ravi. Now, this is the, what is the, you see that the, in 1875, two British engineers was laying railway track from Karachi to Lahore, and then they discovered that very, this ancient civilization. And later it was excavated by John Marshall, the director of the Archaeological Survey of India, and he coined the term Indus Valley Civilization, coined by him. Sir John Marshall or Howard Marshall. Now, we see that the, what is the meaning of the term Mohenjo-daro? Mohenjo-daro in Sindhi language, it means mound of dead. And Harappa means food of Lord Shiva. Food of Lord Shiva. Now, we see that the, this is the development, and now question may come, what is civilization? Civilization is a developed stage of society. We see that the, and in which people lead a very prosperous and settled life. Civilization emerged in Mesopotamia, in Egypt, and many other countries of the world, and it is also known as Indus Valley Civilization. However, the archaeologists or historians prefer to call it Harappan Civilization. Why? Because the first site we have discovered, the Harappa, and most of the artifacts which are found in, we have discovered in Harappa, had close similarity with other sites. Now, when, what is the date of the, this civilization, Indus Valley Civilization? It may be assumed that it flourished between 2600 BC to 1900 BC. It also says that this civilization belonged to the Chalcolithic age, copper stone age or bronze age. Bronze, you know, it is an alloy mixed with copper and tin. And now, this is also known as bronze civilization or Chalcolithic age civilization. Now, already have discussed about the excavation done by Dayaram Sahani and Rakhaldas Bandyopadhyay. Now, extent and main sites. We know that this civilization has spread over many areas, you know, Sindh or Baluchistan, Sindh, Baluchistan, and Punjab, Haryana, Gujarat, Rajasthan, etc. In the north, from Jammu to Narmada River in the south. This is the extent. The total area covered 1,299,600 square kilometer, and many sites have been discovered. Many sites. Of them, I can mention few: Rupar in Punjab, Lothal, and Dholavira (Dholavira) Dholavira in Gujarat, Kalibangan in Rajasthan, Banwal in Haryana, Banwal in Haryana. Now, the town planning. we have excavated a very developed town planning. It was divided into two parts. The citadel part, 30 to 40 feet high from the ground level, and it was called citadel, and another one, town proper or lower town. So what was in the citadel part? There were several buildings we have discovered, large buildings. We can mention the Great Bath in Manjaro, Granary, in Harappa. Great Bath, we see that it is about, we see that a very important discovery we have seen, that in this, perhaps it has actually built with the baked bricks, and it was almost, you can see, 39 feet long, 23 feet wide, and 8 feet deep. And now we see that similarly, granaries were divided into 6 blocks where the grains were stored. And this is the most important discovery. And perhaps the Great Bath, you see that there were in the Great Bath, I'm telling it again, there is a rooms around the Great Bath which was perhaps used for changing the clothes. And perhaps it was the people take the bath on some religious occasion. And there was a system of water drainage, and the used water could be drained out and fresh water could be brought in. And there is a system of, see that this system was prevalent in the Great Bath. Now, lower town, it is the common people who live there. There is a small houses where the different types of people, however, one thing we must remember, in the citadel part, the rich people, the higher class of people lived, merchants lived there. And while the lower people, the poor people, the generally craftsmen, workers lived there. And it was, we see that there are different types of buildings, from one story, two story buildings, each and every house has a courtyard. And also it had also bathrooms, each and every house. There is a kitchen, and which every house is connected with there is a drainage system within the house, and the drainage of the within the, I mean, each and every house connected with the drain with the outside. There is a sewerage system, and the drainage system was the most unique. We found that we have not found such type of system in Mesopotamia and Egypt. And this is the most marvelous architectural architecture they used, and drainage system. The streets are very wide. It is said that 10 feet, or it is said somewhere in book, it is 30 feet wide and 800 meter long. The streets were actually, we see that it was, we can see the streets cut across another, you see that in perpendicularly dividing city in different blocks. And we see that the dockyard, we have found a dockyard that is the in Lothal in Sabarmati, you see that the Sabarmati River, on the bank of Sabarmati River, which had a connection with the Arabian Sea, a Gulf of Cambay. And this dockyard is the most important discovery, and where it clearly proved that it had developed trade and relation with the other countries of the world, Mesopotamia, Egypt, etc. And trade and commerce was carried on from Lothal to other countries of the world, namely Mesopotamia and Egypt. Now, we see that what was the life of the people? The people, we know that generally common people used to cultivate the land. They used to produce barley, wheat, rice, and millet. And also they used to take the milk products, meat, fish. Different types of bones of the animals have been discovered. And namely, I can mention here the bone of sheep, goat, bull, and also dog, and many other elephants even, but we have not unearthed or excavated any, or we have not found any bone of horse. Perhaps it is not, it was not prevalent, not domesticated. Now, different types of crabs, different types of earthen vessels have been excavated. The red in color and black, red and black ware, and it was also used for storing grains. And we see that the similarly, we have found different types of toys made of clay, and also the most important discovery in the field of crafts, that is the dancing girl, image of a bronze made dancing girl, and also a priest, image of, we see that the bust of a priest, a torso of a priest. You see that the perhaps he may be king or a priest, that was discovered. Moreover, we see that clay spindles were also, it was used for weaving. We have found needles and similarly weights and measures, different blocks, stone, you see that the made of stone. And seals, we have discovered 2000 seals have been discovered. It was made of steatite or soft stone. And in the different types of seals, we have found different types of pictures engraved on it, namely one horned rhino, or you see that the I can say elephant, and also different types of other animals, and also the picture of a Lord Shiva, a mother goddess, etc. The seals perhaps used for trading purpose. We have also discovered similar type of seals in Mesopotamia, and perhaps it was used for trading or stamp the goods. Next, we see that the trade and commerce, it had established a commercial link with Mesopotamia and Egypt. We see that the many places we have found, like the Dilmun, and we see that the many other places. We see that the name has been given Meluha, perhaps in Mohenjo-daro, and Dilmun, Baharin, Dilmun, and also Meluha. And they also exported many things like the ivory, peacock, or various, we see that the other materials, other things, commodities, and similarly, they brought from outside the precious stones like lapis lazuli, and also many other precious stones are brought by them. Now, we see that the religious belief of the people. Religious belief, we see that we have found that they used to worship the people tree, and also different types of animals, the bulls, was the they worship bull, the people tree, and also the different types of stones have been found, cone-shaped stone. And religion, we see that we have also discovered a seal of Pashupati. It is actually one archaeologist, John Marshall, says it can be compared to Pashupati, because a yogi in seated posture with two horns in his headgear is surrounded by beasts or animals. Now it can be called the early form of Pashupati or Lord Shiva. Now we have also unearthed different types of female figurines, and we can understand that they used to worship mother goddess. Mother goddess, you know that similarly we have also found various scripts. It is called Indus Valley scripts. These Indus Valley scripts are pictographic in nature. There are various pictures, and also the scripts which were engraved on it could not be even deciphered. It could not be read out, and it still remained undeciphered. Several scripts have been, it is called Indus Valley scripts, have been discovered. And the most important, how the civilization ended. Indus Valley civilization ended or declined due to various reasons. Maybe it natural calamities like flood, earthquake, you see that maybe the other reasons, we can see that. Similarly, I can say the foreign invasion may be one of the reason, perhaps the Aryan invasion, which led to the decline of the Indus Valley civilization. Similarly, the fertility of the soil declined, the salinity of the soil increased, and another. So this is how we see that the different reason may be assumed for the decline of the Harappan civilization. So thank you. We will discuss it again if necessary in detail.